Hi, welcome to Savvy's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. In this class, I'll be showing how to use this flower stitch foot, which is fun and easy to use. Using this foot and a regular zigzag stitch on your machine or any other design stitch on your machine, you can create so many different circular patterns. I'll be demonstrating on my Juki HZL70HW home sewing machine. You can see here, using this foot, I created all these circular patterns. And in the next part of this video, I'll show how to use this ruffler foot, which is used to make these ruffles. And in the third part of this video, we will do this cushion and cushion cover from scratch to finish. So let's start with the class. I'm using my Juki HZL70HW sewing machine. In our previous classes, we have already shown in detail about this sewing machine. Now let's see how to install this flower stitch foot. First of all, remove the regular presser foot and also the shank. To remove the shank, loosen the screw. Now take your flower stitch foot. This bar here should go behind the needle bar. This is very important. That is behind the screw which is used to release the needle. And also raise the needle to the highest position. Now take it from behind. Place this bar behind the needle bar. And this will go here. Once it's in place, tighten the screw. Now it's installed. Now thread the machine. I'm using a silk thread here. You can use embroidery thread or even regular sewing thread. Now select the pattern that you want to sew. Now the pattern you see here on your machine, when sewn with the flower stitch, will come very different. So you need to try on a scrap fabric and see which pattern you like. And before starting, also lower the feed dog. Now why this is done is, the feed dog pushes the fabric forward, whereas this foot rotates the fabric. So disabling the feed dog will give a neater stitch. So let me lower the feed dog. Now very important before starting to sew is check the stitch width. Now if you see here, the stitch width is 7, and if I try to sew, the needle is hitting this bar and the needle would break if you continue sewing. So before starting with any stitch, just check that the needle is not hitting the bar. If it does, you need to reduce the stitch width. Now I'll reduce it to 5. As you reduce, you can see the needle moving. Now I've set the stitch width at 5, and now you see it. The needle is not hitting the bar. I have lowered the feed dog, but if you do not have that option to lower the feed dog, do not use the feed dog cover plate. Instead, set your stitch length to 0. I'll be using this fabric, and it's always good to use a stabilizer or interfacing below the fabric to avoid puckering while stitching. So place the fabric, and you can select the zigzag stitches or any of the designer stitches available in your machine. First, I'll be using the zigzag stitch, that is pattern 6 in this. And the stitch width is 5. So I'll reduce it slightly. So I made it 4. Now the needle does not hit the bar here. Now this screw is to select the size. We'll start with the small size and then I'll show you the other two sizes. Do a few stitches and cut off this excess thread carefully using a trimmer. And then continue sewing. Now this design is complete, and once it's complete, you need to lock the stitch. Chain to straight stitch and lift this bar here and do 3 stitches. So the stitches are locked. Now you may remove the fabric. Now let's see the next size. To set the next size, loosen this screw and move this disc to the next size. That is, this pointer here should be pointing at the next line. Now tighten the screw. I'll be using the same pattern. Now let's see the biggest size. Loosen the screw and move the disc to the last size here and tighten. So these are the 3 sizes you can make: 1/4 inch, 1/2 inch, and 3/4 inch. And based on your pattern, you can make so many variations. That is, with one single pattern, just by changing the width or length of the stitch. And by changing the size here, you can create different variations. So let's see some of the patterns. So I'm selecting pattern 9. And as told before, check the stitch width. Also, to change the color of the thread, you only can change the needle thread. So this is the one we made just now. So the design you see in your pattern chart may be completely different when you do it with the flower stitch foot. So try different patterns and see which one you like before using it in your project. Let me try a few more. I'm changing to the medium size. If the fabric you're using is big, then you may have to slowly guide the fabric. And after each design, you don't need to remove the fabric. You can just move on to the next place where you want to do the design. Lower the presser foot. Cut off this thread what you see. You can also do one flower inside the other. Let me show that. You can do a small flower first and then do a bigger one. Or you can do a bigger one first and then do a smaller one. Either way, it's fine. So let's do the bigger one first. I've selected the bigger size. I'll continue with the same pattern. Now, we'll use a different color thread to do the inner flower. If you wish, you can continue with the same color thread. So, I'm only changing the needle thread. Now, once you have changed the needle thread, loosen the screw and move the disc and the fabric together to the smaller size. And then tighten the screw. You can't remove the fabric and then try to center it. It would not come right. So we have done the large one and the medium, and we'll also try a smaller one inside this. So if you wish, you can chain the thread or continue with the same. I'll just chain the thread. I've chained the thread. Now loosen the screw and shift the disc and the fabric together to the lower size. Now tighten the screw. So this is made with all three sizes. Before using on the actual project, practice on scrap fabric. Now also let's see how to use the twin needle with this presser foot. First let me remove this needle. You'll get different kinds of twin needles with difference in the distance between the needles. We'll be making a separate class on different needles and how to use them. Tighten it completely. You cannot use the needle threader when you're using the twin needle. So one of the threads go to the left needle and use another spool for the right needle. When using a twin needle, you need to be extra careful about the width you select because the width needs to be further reduced as there are two needles now, and if the width is more, they will hit the bar here and break the needle. So the pattern I've selected is 44 and I've kept the stitch width at 3. So this is how it looks when done with twin needle, and this is another design with twin needle. So I made this in different colors and different patterns, which I'll be using to make a cushion cover. Thanks for watching this class, and if you like this class, please like, share and subscribe. See you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing.